anger management. Are you a youth? Are you a young adult? Are you a teen who could be struggling in this area of your life? Let's have a chat right here at Youth Cafe. My name is Linda Mwaniki and you are watching Sitam Church Online. We see it all around us. We see it in the movies. We can even see it in the streets. We see it in our families. We see it amongst our colleagues. Anger outbursts, where someone is in a conversation and with someone and they are trying to prove that, they're trying to prove a point. They're trying to show that I am the one who has the say. I am the one who has the say in this conversation. And let's find out, what exactly does the Bible say about anger and anger outbursts and how we can be able to manage it? We'll be looking at Proverbs chapter 10 verse 19, and it says, when there are many words, transgression and offense are unavoidable, but he who controls his lips and keeps thoughtful silence is wise. I'd like us to just focus on the first part of this scripture where it says again, when there are many words, transgression and offense are unavoidable. It's clear that God is saying you cannot be able to avoid an offense. You cannot be able to avoid either a physical violence offense. You cannot be able to avoid, some cases also there's murder in arguments. At times you also find that someone gets out of that argument with a lot of pride, that I have made a statement, that all eyes were on me and I got the attention at that moment. But I'd like us to continue and see, what exactly do we need to do? If you find yourself in that situation where you're arguing with someone and this person is trying to lash out words at you and trying to show that I am the one who is in charge of this. I'm the one who is in charge of this atmosphere. This is what you should do. It says, but he who controls his lips and keeps thoughtful silence is wise. You know what? Just be silent. In that moment and in that conversation, be quiet and find time with yourself and move out of that conversation. If you can, get out of that environment and go to a place where gather your thoughts together, gather your thoughts together, and if you can, go back to that person and talk to them, you know, and clear out the air with them. Because the Bible says that let no unwholesome talk come out of your mouth. What should only come out of your mouth is that which is profitable to the other person. So I challenge you today, if you find yourself in that situation where you are arguing with someone and you're lashing outwards with someone, find time to just be silent and to be quiet and to hold your tongue. I know you may see it as a form of weakness, but in actual sense, it's strength that is coming out of you. And what you leave out of it is a badge of honor, and the badge of honor is wisdom. It is wisdom from God, because the Bible says that he who holds his tongue is wise. So are you in this situation? Are you struggling with anger? Are you struggling with anger outbursts? I'd like to just pray for you that the peace of God will overwhelm you at that particular moment. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your viewers. I thank you, King of all glory, for that teen who is watching me today, Jehovah God, that youth, that young adult, King of all glory, ask that, Father, your peace shall superintend over them in the name of Jesus Christ, O God. I pray, King of all glory, that you may help them to work out their anger management in the name of Jesus. We give you thanks and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do you have any comments? Do you have any experiences that you'd like to share with us? Feel free to leave them at the comment section below. My name is Linda Mwaniki. You are watching Sitam Church Online right here at Youth Cafe. Thank you.